बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ उमैरा सईद, लेक्चर इंग्लिश टाइम्स इंस्टीट्यूट पाकिस्तान। एज द सीरीज ऑफ द लेक्चर्स विच वी स्टार्टेड द लास्ट वीक इन विच वी वर डिस्कसिंग द पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीचेस इन डिटेल एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंसिवली, इट इज़ द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दैट पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच सेशन। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द इंटरजेक्शन एंड द कंजंक्शन, एंड वी विल जस्ट स्केच आउट एंड अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ द इंटरजेक्शन, व्हाट आर द वर्ड्स विच आर यूज्ड एज एन इंटरजेक्शन इन अ सेंटेंस, व्हाट आर द कंजंक्शन। वी विल नॉट गो एंड डिग आउट द डेप्थ ऑफ कंजंक्शन, बट वी विल जस्ट कवर द आउटलाइन दैट व्हाट एक्चुअली द कंजंक्शन इज। सो पिक अप योर पेंसिल एंड द पेपर्स एंड नोट डाउन सम इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। एज आई यूज्ड टू मेंशन डेली that all your exercises will be provided in your WhatsApp group, so stay in touch. And if you find any difficulty of understanding anything, so it is an age of technology, you may rewind the video and you may understand the most difficult point as well. Interjection is basically a word, a part of a speech which is used in a sentence. It is to express some emotion. It is a kind of an emotional speech. It is used in their actual form and in actual words. In our language, we embellished it with the different interjections. Like emotion is the part of language. You cannot skip the emotion out of your speech. When we speak the native, or you may say the mother tongue, we use so many emotional touches add in it, while there are some emotional words or emotions which are associated with the European language or some other English as a vernacular language as well. Number one is ooh, ah, yes, no, hurrah, oh no, oof, wow, gosh, what, where, yes. These are the words which commonly been used in the spoken language. There are few slangs which have been used and which have been using by the people in their language, but they cannot be expressed in the lecture in an academic session as well. So few words such as two. It is the same way in which we in Urdu language we said, if when we said tuch, gosh, guli, oh god, oof, oh, what, no, yes, where, bravo, wonderful, yuppie. These are the few words. Maybe you would have an, you may increase the list according to your choice, but these are the few words which you may use in your sentences and in your regular life speech, and you may add these words in your formal sessions and in your informal language as well. But the most appropriate and the properly definition is that these interjections are generally used in an informal communication rather than the formal. Like in a formal communication, when you are on interview, or you, if you are being a tutor, if you are at some class session, you may not use these words. But yes, emotions, as I mentioned previously, that you cannot skip the emotions out of your language. So these words are very much helpful to embellish your language. So these are the interjection. You may use these words in your sentences. You may make your sentences by your own choice as well. So this is the interjection. So the next topic which I have lined up for today's discussion, that is going to be the last lecture regarding the parts of the speech, and that is conjunction. So give me any idea which you have related with the conjunction. What do you know about the conjunction? Like I may tell that junction is a kind of a place where so many things are associated and interact with each other. So conjunction is a word which is used to join words, phrases, and clauses. Like when two sentences are joining by a word is said to be the conjunction. It can be and, because, but, also, although, yet. So these are the few words which can be used as conjunction. So the simplest definition of a conjunction is that a parts of the speech which is very much helpful in joining the two sentences, two clauses, two phrases, and give a meaning to a sentence is said to be conjunction. Now, there are three different types of conjunctions. Number one is coordinating, number two is subordinating, and number three is the correlative conjunction. Now, what are the coordinating conjunctions? Coordinating junctions are which joins the clauses of equal rank. So first of all, you must know what actually the clause is. The clause is a sentence which has its own subject and predicate. Now, if in the previous lectures we discussed that in a sentence we have the three basic things, the subject, verb, and object. It is the conventional method of understanding the subject, verb, object, but the new grammarian has suggested that the now sentence is not divided into the three parts, now it may be divided into subject and verb, and object becomes the predicate. It doesn't mean that we are skipping the verb and object out of the sentence, but verb and object combinedly becomes a predicate. So if you have if you are writing a long sentence, and if that long sentence have two subjects and the two predicates in a sentence, it means that that sentence has been divided into two different clauses. This is the place where we live. It seems to be very simple sentence, but this sentence has two clauses. Subject, predicate, subject, predicate, like it is verb. And as we have discussed in the verb session, that the sentence is possible without subject, sentence is possible without object, but it is impossible to have a sentence without the verb. So you may have a different kinds of a verb, as well as we discuss that those sentences which have a verb which needs an object, and those sentences which do not needs an object. And you may recall that lecture of verb as well. So this is the clauses of equal rank, because both clauses can exist without each other. We live, it can be exist an independent sentence. This is the place, it can be exist an independent place. And where is a word which is being added into the sentence and working as a conjunction, as well as in the session of adverb we discuss, it is a adverb of place as well. But here, when we are discussing about the two conjunction, the where will be used as a glue, as a tape, or as some binding forces to join the two clauses of an equal rank having an equal sentence, subject and predicate. So this is a coordinated conjunction. The word which are used for the coordinating conjunction can also be and, but, for, or, nor, and also. The second is the subordinate conjunctions. The subordinate conjunctions are those conjunctions in which the sentences are joined with each other, but one is a principal clause and other is the dependent clause. So what is the principal clause? The clause which exists at its own cost, but the subordinating conjunction, like subordinating clause, is those which may depend upon the other to like to exist. The number three is correlative conjunction. The conjunctions which are based in the form of group, like either, or, neither, nor, not only, but also. So these are the few conjunctions which can be used in the form of groups, like neither Saima nor Amna passed the exam. It means that here we are using the correlative conjunctions to join the two sentences and making a complete sense out of that. So my dear student, this was just an outline of a conjunction and the interjection. I hope that you would understand. Your practicing exercises will be provided so soon. So take care. Allah Hafiz.